Hi everyone, it's Jillian and welcome back to my channel Hooked and Smitten and another crochet tutorial. Let's get started and making this very interesting square pattern. You're going to start with a magic ring. Chain two. And that chain two doesn't count as a stitch. Inside the ring, you're going to make three double crochets. You're going to chain two, and this is going to be the start of your repeat. You're now going to make three double crochets inside the ring. And you're going to repeat two more times. You're going to chain two, three double crochets into the ring. Chain two, and three double crochets inside the ring. Chain two at the end, and you're going to join with a slip stitch to the first double crochet stitch. You're going to fasten off here. And you're going to go ahead and make four more. And you can make them all in the same color if you choose to, it doesn't matter. For round two, we're going to be joining in the middle double crochet stitch. We have three double crochets, one, two, three, and we're going to use the center one. And I'm going to join with a standing double crochet, a slip stitch, and a chain three works just fine. For standing double crochet, you're going to put a slip knot on your hook. You're going to wrap your hook once, and you're going to go in to the stitch. You're going to pull up a loop. You have three loops there on your hook. You're going to wrap your hook and pull through two, and wrap your hook and pull through two. Okay, and that is your standing double crochet stitch. In the next stitch, you're going to make a double crochet. Into the chain two, you're going to make two double crochets. You're going to chain one, and you're going to join the next square, but you're going to join from the top down with a slip stitch, and you're going to continue by making, you're just going to move that square out of the way because it's going to try and flop around. Into the same chain two, you're going to continue by making two double crochets. You're going to make, and this is going to be the start of your repeat. You're going to make one double crochet into the next three stitches, the next three double crochets. And into the chain two, you're going to make two double crochets. Chain one. And you're going to add your second square. Remembering you're going from the top down with a slip stitch. And you're going to continue with two double crochets into that same chain two space. You're going to make one double crochet into the next three stitches, the next three double crochets. And you're going to repeat what we did here, and you're going to add the next two squares, and I'll meet you at the end. At the end of the round, you have one double crochet left from the one that you skipped in the beginning, and you're going to make one double crochet into that stitch. And then you're going to join with a slip stitch. And then you're going to cut your yarn here, and you're going to switch colors to the next round. So that's the end of round two here. For round three, you can join in any of the chain two spaces that you like. I'm going to start my join here, and I'm going to be joining with a standing single crochet. For standing single crochet, you're going to put a slip knot on your hook. You can also use a slip stitch, a chain one, and then make a single crochet that way. You're going to go into the space and you're going to pull up a loop. You have two loops on your hook, and you're going to wrap your hook and pull through those two loops. You're now going to make one single crochet into the next three stitches. Into the chain two, you're going to make a single crochet, chain two, and a single crochet. You're going to make one single crochet into the next two stitches. And here you're at a corner, and you're going to single crochet two stitches together. So you're going to go into the next stitch and pull up a loop. You're going to be ignoring the chain two space here, and then you're going to go over to round two, and you're going to pull up a loop into the next double crochet stitch here. You have three loops on your hook. You're going to wrap your hook and pull through all three loops. And that is your single crochet two stitches together. You're going to continue, and you're going to make one single crochet into the next five stitches. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And you add another corner, and you're going to repeat what you did in the previous corner. You're going to pull up a loop into the next stitch. You're going to ignore the chain two space, and then you're going to go over to the next double crochet stitch from the next motif here, the next square, and you're going to pull up a loop, and you have three loops on your hook, and you're going to pull through all three loops. And you're going to continue by making one double crochet into the next two stitches. Into the chain two, a single crochet, chain two, and a single crochet. You're going to make one single crochet into the next three stitches. Into the chain two, a single crochet, chain two, and another single crochet. One single crochet into the next three stitches. So you're working the square all the way around until you get to the next corner. Into the chain two, a single crochet, chain two, and a single crochet. So now that you're coming up on your corner, what you're going to do is you're going to make a single crochet into the next two stitches. And then you're going to work your corner here, where you're going to single crochet two stitches together by going into the next stitch, pull up a loop. Remember that you're ignoring the chain two, and then you're going to go over to the next double crochet stitch. And you're going to pull through all loops. And that is going to be your repeat all the way around. And if you get a little bit lost, there'll be a timestamp, and you can go back and see what I did and just continue that all the way around, and I will meet you at the end here. At the end of the round, you're going to make a single crochet into the chain two, and you're going to join, you're going to chain one first, and then you're going to join into the first stitch with a single crochet. And that is the end of round one, and your pattern should be looking something like this. For round four, you're going to chain one, and you're going to make a single crochet into the chain two space, and you made a chain two space when you ended round three with a chain one and a single crochet join. So into that space right here, you're going to make a single crochet. And you're going to start your repeat by making one single crochet into the next five stitches, and that's going to bring you to your next chain two space. So one single crochet into the next five stitches. One, two, three, four, and five. And you're at your chain two space, and into the chain two, you're going to make one single crochet, chain two, and another single crochet. You're now going to make one single crochet into the next two stitches. One and two. And you're at a corner, and you're going to single crochet two stitches together. And to do this, you are going to be skipping over one stitch. So you're going to go into the next stitch and pull up a loop. You're going to skip the next stitch, and over to the next stitch, you're going to pull up a loop. And you're going to pull through all three loops. And you're going to make one single crochet into the next stitch until you get into the next two stitches. One, two, actually into the next three stitches. And you add another corner, and you're going to repeat what you did in the first corner, and you're going to single crochet two stitches together, skipping one, the stitch in the middle. So go into the stitch, and you're going to pull up a loop, skip the next stitch, and go in to the next one and pull up a loop. You're going to pull through all three loops. Okay, you're now going to continue by making one single crochet into the next two stitches, and you're going to be at your chain two space, and into your chain two, you're going to make a single crochet, chain two, and another single crochet. And you're going to work your square all the way around to the next corner. You're going to make a single crochet into the next five stitches. That's going to bring you to the next chain two space. Two, three, four, and five. At your chain two space, you're going to make your single crochet, chain two, and a single crochet. Okay, and you're going to make one single crochet into the next five, all the way to the next corner. Single crochet into the corner and a chain two, and one more single crochet. Now you're getting ready to work your next corner, so you're going to make one single crochet into the next two, you're going to go into the next stitch and pull up a loop, you're going to skip the next one and pull up a loop into the next stitch. And you're going to pull through all loops. And that is going to be your repeat for round four, all the way around. So you're going to repeat this all the way around, and I will meet you at the end of the round. Into the chain two space, you're going to make a single crochet, chain one, and you're going to join with a single crochet to the first stitch. And I'm going to switch colors here, and I'm going to have a new color for round five. And I'm just going to pull my new color through. I'm just going to cut this here, and I'm just going to make a tie just to keep that in place for round five. And this is what your pattern should look like at the end of round 4. For round 5, you're going to chain 1 and you're going to make a single crochet into that chain 2 space right here, just like you did in the previous round. You're going to make a single crochet and you're going to make 1 single crochet into the next 7 stitches, and this is going to be the start of your repeat for round 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. And that brings you to your chain 2 space, and you're going to make a single crochet into the chain 2, chain 2, and another single crochet. You're going to make 1 single crochet into the next 2 stitches. And you're going to make an increase in the corner here. So you're going to go into the next stitch and pull up a loop. You're going to skip the next stitch and pull up a loop into the next. You're going to make 1 single crochet into the next stitch. And you have another corner stitch. You're going to go in, pull up a loop into the next stitch, skip the next one, and pull up a loop into the next. You're going to single crochet 2 stitches together. You're going to continue by making 1 single crochet into the next 2 stitches, and that's going to bring you to your next chain 2 space, where you're going to make a single crochet, chain 2, and another single crochet. And you're going to single crochet into the next 7 stitches, and that's going to bring you to your next corner stitch. And 7. And into your chain 2, you're going to make your single crochet, chain 2, and your single crochet. So this is your repeat, and you're going to repeat that for the next 3 sides, and I will meet you at the end. You're going to make a single crochet into the chain 2, chain 1, and join with a single crochet stitch. And I'll be switching colors here again. For round 6, you're going to chain 1. And you're going to make a single crochet into that first chain 2 space. And for round 6, we're going to be skipping 1 stitch after each chain 2 space. So you're going to skip that first stitch and make a single crochet into the next 8 stitches. And that's going to bring us to the chain 2 space. And this is also the start of a repeat for round 6. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Into the chain 2, you're going to make your single crochet, chain 2, and another single crochet. Skipping 1 stitch after the chain 2, you're going to make 1 single crochet into the next 2 stitches. We're now going to single crochet 2 stitches together, the same way we've been doing it all along. You're going to go into the next stitch, pull up a loop, skip the next one, pull up a loop into the next stitch, and pull through all 3 loops for your single crochet 2 stitches together. We're going to skip a stitch here and make a single crochet into the next one. Pull up on that loop, and you're going to skip that single crochet two stitches together, and you're going to go into the next stitch opposite that stitch. You're going to place that loop back onto your hook, and you're going to pull that through. Working into the next stitch on the left, you're going to make a single crochet. And you're going to pull up on that loop. And you're going to go over to the next stitch here. You're going to place that loop back onto your hook. And you're going to pull it through. You're now going to make a single crochet into the chain two. You're going to pull up on that loop. And here on the left side, you're going to skip that next stitch, and you're going to go into the chain two space. You're going to place that loop onto your hook, and you're going to pull that through. You're going to chain two. And into the chain two space on the left, you're going to make a single crochet. You're going to skip the next stitch. Remembering after the chain two to skip that one stitch and make one single crochet into the next 8 stitches all the way to the chain two space. And this is going to be your stitch repeat for round 6. So you're going to repeat this on all 3 sides, and I will meet you at the end. And you can always go back and check this timestamp to see what I did here to complete the round. At the end of the round, you're going to make a single crochet into the chain 2, chain 1, and join with a single crochet stitch. And for this last round, I'm going to switch colors one more time. So that's the end of round 6, and we're going to get ready for round 7. For round 7, you're going to chain 1, and that chain 1 counts as a stitch. You're now going to make one single crochet into the next 10 stitches. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. And now you're at your corner stitch right here, and you're going to make one single crochet into that chain 2 space. And you're going to make a single crochet into the next space where you made that stitch in the middle. You're going to make a single crochet there. And into the next corner stitch, your next chain 2 right there, you're going to make a single crochet. And you're going to make one single crochet into the next 10 stitches all the way to your corner space. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. So now you're at your chain 2, and you're going to make your single crochet, chain 2, and your single crochet for your corner. So for round 7, this is your stitch repeat, and you're going to repeat it on the remaining 3 sides, and I'll meet you at the end. At the end of the round, you're going to make a single crochet into the chain two space. You're going to chain two and you're going to cut your yarn here and fasten off. And I'm going to join to the first stitch on the boat loops. And then I'm going to go into the back loop of the chain two. And then you're just going to go ahead and sew in your ends. And that is the end of the tutorial. As always, thank you so much for visiting my channel. Please like and subscribe for more video tutorials, and I will see you in the next video.